So we're always looking for the best way that we can bring digital pedagogy into the classroom. And QLearn has been a way for us to do that. We really value all of our students being able to access quality education and also that privileging of digital pedagogy, which is obviously coming through the equity and excellence framework as well.
So we're moving from one learning management system to another, trying to navigate all that. But out of that comes some very productive thinking. So I think from a student's point of view, what this meant was we spent some time thinking about how do we set this up in a way that reduces cognitive load for kids? How do we make sure that they're not spending all their brain power, their mental capacity in trying to navigate a system and can focus their energies and their thinking on what we want them to do, their learning?
QLearn is good, but you do have to invest the time to get to know the system. Once you know it and once you know what your plan is and what that looks like, I think the implementation's fairly easy. Most of your time is spent planning and thinking. The doing part is then straightforward. But if you don't have the plan, the doing is all over the place.
It was that change in practice to go, okay, I'm no longer going to work in a silo. I'm going to work as a team. We're going to come up with what's best practice and we're going to put it in our best practice blueprint. And that's going to be there for next year. And then we will reflect on that and we will build on it and build on it and build on it.
So to save time, you need to invest time, and QLearn's definitely an investment worth making.
I think a lot of our staff were initially like, oh, QLearn, we don't want to have to do another thing. And so by creating the blueprints and the templates, we've taken that layer of worry away from them. The idea being that by the end of the year, you've got a year's worth of planning and sharing sitting there. So if we all get switched around year levels, you inherit some planning to start from work from, and that's the other big point of workload reduction.
Essentially, what we're aiming to do is change the culture across the school and promote this understanding that through collaboration on the same course, we can actually improve all of the students' experiences in the classroom, not just one class that has A experience and another class has a different experience. So we draw from all teachers' expertise and strong points to actually deliver those learning activities.
What we've found is that QLearn's been an incredible tool in terms of engaging our students and developing their own technology skills. So my advice would be to use that as the vehicle in which to develop capability, not just in your own staff, but in students as well. So in turn, it's a tool in which you can develop ICT capability generally. You know, we're certainly thinking about different ways that we can use QLearn across the school, whether it's for student and curriculum delivery, or whether it's actually for looking at how do we create courses internally to support our staff, particularly in terms of induction, our school priorities, onboarding staff, professional learning opportunities. So I think this has opened a gateway of opportunities for our staff in terms of how can we use QLearn to support professionally our community as well. What's been a significant shift, I think, for our staff has been using QLearn to engage students, using QLearn to meet the diverse needs of students, and using QLearn to also make reasonable adjustments. And I think that that has fit really well into our focus on differentiation and data-driven decision-making.
Particularly in the QLearn platform, we created templated courses that really tried to simplify the user experience, which is ultimately our students, and secondly, our teachers. Building trust with individual users was key to help them access the platform and help them understand that it's not necessarily something that we're expecting them to be experts at straight away, and help building on their knowledge on the go is an important way to develop their skill set and ultimately move forward with the progress that they're making.
Previously, if you had some sort of LMS, we have a IT staff, and their job on a Wednesday was to enroll new students and new teachers into all the platforms we have, because we didn't have that integration. What happens now is it just happens. So we get 8 new staff like we did starting here because of contracts and things that had finished or teachers had gone on leave. Those new staff are automatically enrolled when the timetable rolls into QLearn. We have lots of subject change, class changes here. Kids come in, we have new enrolments on a daily basis. So keeping up with that is quite difficult, but the integration has made it super easy.